Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. So in this video, I made a forest axe, or a utility axe as I like to call them, because they're very versatile. You can use them for almost anything. And it's also like the axe that you, when I was a kid at least, you imagine you, when you, someone said axe, this shape and form of the handle and everything was what I at least imagined when someone said that. So something that you can use for almost anything, everything from felling a tree to chopping some woods for a fire or whatever. It's very good to have around. It's slightly bigger than a camp axe perhaps. I don't know exactly how big they are, but it's a very versatile tool, and I made this especially for myself and to make a video for you guys. So the last time I made one of these was probably last fall at least, and even though I really enjoy making the bearded axes, it's very fun to do something different. So for example, the whole process of this is different than making the bearded axes. It's made from one solid piece of steel that I inlay the high carbon steel end bit at the end. So the steel that we begin with, it is mild steel, or as we call it in Sweden, bonjärn, or construction steel. It's basically the same thing, non-hardenable steel basically, with high carbon steel end bit. I really like the fact that you punch and drift the eye, and it's something that probably would be a lot easier if you had a press or a bigger power hammer. As you can see in my videos, my power hammer isn't really up to the task to these big billets or big pieces of steel. It's very good for drawing out smaller stock, but the hammer actually broke during forging of this hammer. So I had to rebuild it a little bit and fix it. But at the same time, I also poured some more lead into the ram of the hammer, and it actually made a quite huge difference. So all of a sudden I can draw out the blade of the axe a little bit more easier. But mostly I did made it by hand so that you could see the process. But if I were to make another of these, I would probably use the hammer, the power hammer, quite a bit more. So the handle is just simple hickory handle that I had laying around. For myself, I usually use the scraps that I didn't use for one of the axes that I sell. So it was a scrap handle that I had laying around, and it worked fine. I had to remove some, the scrap part was the end here where the hole, it wasn't centered and it was not straight. So I cut that piece off and made the handle out of this. So fairly happy with the result. Sharp, cuts well, what you would like from an axe. So in the future here during the summer, there's a lot of things going on. For example, I'm going away in 2 weeks to record some stuff for, well, I'll probably not spoil that now, so I'll give you that update in a later video. But there are a lot of things going on outside of the YouTube channel which I need to take care of during the summer, a lot of orders, but also a lot of planning for future videos. So coming this summer, I am going to try my best to make a Dane axe, which is quite the project for me at least. There are smiths out there who make incredible Dane axes, and hats off to them. But depending on what type of Dane axe you want to make, the process is quite demanding. So I'm planning on starting filming that in a couple of weeks. So I need time for that video. It's gonna be a little bit longer video, more details and stuff that I've never tried before. I'm also going to build a hydraulic forging press, which also will be on the YouTube channel. So I'm quite nervous about that. I'm going to get the parts for that the day after this video airs. So wish me luck. It could be a disastrous business for me if I buy the wrong stuff, but I hope that I plan this good enough. So yeah, a lot of stuff going on. Hopefully I will be getting videos out as usual, but if not, you know why. There's a lot of planning to do and a lot of stuff going on in the business. So if you like the video, please leave a like. If you have any questions or suggestions for what I should do in future videos, please leave them in the comment section. Consider subscribing if you like videos like this. It helps out a lot. And I also started a Patreon page fairly recently. I haven't talked anything about it because I wasn't sure what I was going to put up there and if it would be worth the time. But I'm gonna start making some, you know, in the shop videos, like more talkative videos, like my thought process around things while they're happening, basically. And I also have a Discord channel that the Patreons can use if they want, and we will have some chats there as well. So yeah, if you like to support the channel, you can do that via Patreon, but it's not necessary at all. Only if you really, really want to. It would be much appreciated, of course. So once again, thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Have a great day. Goodbye.